Good morning, everybody. Let's raise our hands and give an applause to all of us. Come on, let's applause. Come on, we can do it. Let's do it. And you know why we're applauding? You know why? Because you're all here. You're all special. You woke up and you decided to be here because you deserve it, because this is your life, because you're going after your dreams. Because you gave yourself a chance, because you see somebody important in every single one of you. You are the one who drives your life. You're the one who makes your dreams come true. And that's why I am impressed. I admire all of you for coming over here today and not staying at home, not being surrounded by bad influence, not doing drugs, not doing alcohol, not giving up on your life, because you know you're worth it. You know, you've been given a second chance, and you're taking it. That's why you're here today. So that's why I'm proud of all of you, that you guys made that choice, that you guys are important to yourself, to your family, to your brothers or sisters, to your peers over here, that you show up. You say, oh, she's coming. I'm coming too. You know what I'm talking about? You're looking forward to seeing your friends, to tell them whatever happens at home, whatever happens if you guys work or not, or whatever happens you saw on TV. You're looking forward to that interaction. Those are the most small things that drive you every day. Everybody's going to tell you, you're bombarded every single day of your life. What you should do, what you should wear, what you should eat. But take a look in yourself. What do you want? And what you want is what you are here right now. This is who you are right now. And celebrate that you are special. That's why I want to thank you guys, thank you girls, for making an effort every single day of your life. And you know what? This is only a stepping stone. This is not your final destination, but it's part of your destination. This is just a journey. And you guys started already. You guys are going to go far. Because you have something that others don't have. You have hope for yourself. Because you give it yourself. Because you're here. Because now it's important. I can relate to many of you that are immigrants or their family are immigrants. I wanted to share with you, I wasn't born here. I was born in Vietnam. Then I traveled to Belgium, that is in Europe. Then I went to Spain, and then I came to the US. Talk about adaptation. Talk about not fitting in. Talk about everybody trying to put you in a freaking box of who you should be, how you should act, what you should you think. My job is not to tell you what to do. My job is to inspire you to look in yourself and to listen to yourself. What do I want? Well, first of all, you already know what you want. You want to get ahead in life. That's why you're here. It doesn't have to be that you have every single answer in this world. But just like a puzzle, you put one piece, two pieces, three pieces, and then eventually, you will have the whole picture. But enjoy the process. Keep up with the process. This is what's giving you the chance to move forward in life. I understand you totally. You come to a school. Okay, most of them are Latin, Asian, white, and you don't fit in, and you're trying to blend in, you're trying to have that community sense of where you are. But you know what? That is your choice. But I'm telling you from my point of view, that the more I tried to fit in, the more I was lost. Because I was getting away from who I was truly, who I was meant to be. Yeah, people can tell you left and right, black, white, blue, red. But at the end, the one that has the most important in your life is yourself. Yeah, they tell me, I went to Spain, because every single time I went to a different country, you have to establish residency of 1 year. So of course, we get back on the schooling time. So it means that I was always the oldest in the class. So I was already a fish out of water. And on top of that, I was Asian. in people in Europe, they are white. So of course, you know, they call me all kind of names. They laugh at me, they bully me, they beat their eyes like this. And I was like, why? What did I do? I just wanted to go to school. I just wanted to get my life together. I wanted to have my mom. I wanted to move forward. Why are people giving me so much hard time? What did I do? It's not your job to answer all the questions. Your job is to answer your own question about your own life. What am I gonna do? They talk like crap to me. They make me feel like crap. So it's like, what? I'm still going to school because this is what I want. I'm still gonna make my parents proud. And if I can help them financially, I will start working. But all you can do is to try. And at least when you try, you know you won't have regrets that you have tried. Because you know what's the worst thing? Is that you never know what could have happened. Because you will never have an answer of something, of things that you don't do. So, you can tell me all the things I've been bullied. First they told me, you cannot speak Spanish. I'm like, why? Because you cannot. I'm like, really? So I let that one go. And then the one that got me the most, they told me, oh, you should have a Mexican boyfriend, or you should be married to a Mexican boyfriend, that's why you speak Spanish. I'm like, really? I was like, just because you have a notion of what, like, how I could have gotten my Spanish, it doesn't mean that's the truth. The truth, you know it within yourself. And I tell you, it was hard because my mom was a single mom. And the hardships of making through when you don't have money, you don't have language, you don't have the tradition, you don't have anything. But you know what? It's not about what you have. It's what about what you do with what you have. Just imagine right now, they pick you every single one, and they leave you in China. No money, no language, no friends, no job. What would you do? Would you do the best? What you just do right now? Survive and keep on moving forward. That's why you have the skill already. This school teaches you the skill of a drive, of going after what you want, no matter how hard it is, no matter what obstacles are in your life. It's not what they define you, it's what you do in your own life, your choices. And even if you make bad choices, they're still your choices. It's still, you have the greatest thing about this country, the U.S., is that you can change your choices. You may not like this career, you may not like this school, but you have the resources. You can talk to your counselors, you can talk to your teachers, you can do online research, you can have the amazing opportunity to have your cell phones, to feel warm within your clothes. I mean, how blessed we are to have options. So that's why don't be afraid to follow your dreams. And to follow your dreams, the first step is knowledge. Yeah, they say knowledge is power. It is not. It is potential power. You know what's the real power? The real power is action. And you're doing it right now. Let me ask you, what did you want it to be when you were young? You?
Me?
Yes.
I don't remember it.
It's okay. You know, you thought about it because it was inside you. That's why you're here. If you didn't believe in yourself, you wouldn't be here. You're giving the opportunity to think about what you want. What would you want it to be?
I don't know.
You know what? You're beautiful. You know why? Because you already established yourself. This is one of the things by presenting yourself out here in school. You're inspiring all of these girls. Like, man, you know, she gets up, she goes, follows her dreams, and she has that beautiful makeup. You are an inspiration to your peers, too. What would you want it to be when you went down? Dentist. Amazing. Good job. So you like helping people? Yeah. You know what? So you will do it. Because, you know, it's in your heart because you're thinking about it. And that's where it puts you a step ahead of people. And what would you want to be? Okay. The perfect follower. And you know what? Whatever is our dream, whatever is our desires, is valid. As long as we're not hurting anybody, we're trying to build a sense of community. That's why I put this song, because we are all here. Because at the end of the day, we remind ourselves that we will go back to our home, to our parents, to our brothers and sisters. Or even if you have parents, at least to those people that matter to you. Because first of all, when you take care of yourself, you take care of your dreams, you also take care of your loved ones around you. And I tell you, it wasn't easy going through different countries, different schools, but it didn't stop me. I came here, I was 18 years old. I learned English in 3 months because I didn't care. I didn't care how many mistakes. I didn't care if I sounded like a parrot. Well, how do you say this? How do you say that? I didn't care because obstacles are not the one that stops me. The only person that stops you is yourself. So think about it. What will make you feel great right now? You already answered. You're here. But that's what I'm telling you. So I went to Golden West College, got my AA. I was lucky enough, I applied for grants. Like you guys have at the bottom of your evaluation, there's the YMTF scholarship that you can take advantage of $2,000. So you can read that bottom part, and the application is due next March. So $2,000 just for you, just to apply and try your best. And so I got my AA at Golden West College. I was grateful enough that they paid fully for it. Then I went to Cal State Fullerton. I got my Bachelor's of Fine Arts. It took me 5 years. So I was already 7 years of schooling. I was like, what the heck is gonna finish? I feel like I could have been a dentist or a doctor. But then I still kept going, you know what? Because I made a promise to myself that I would finish. Because I'm not a quitter. I'm a doer. I'm a finisher. I finish what I say.
That's right.
Yes. I finish what I say because I respect myself, because I respect my dreams, and I respect my time, and I value myself. And after that, I started working full time, and I got into a financial company. It was not really my dream job, but what paid the bill. But I still pursuing my passion. Then I went to OCC, and I started getting my certificate of TV and film production. That was another 2 years. So I was working full-time and going to school part-time. I don't know how I did it, but it's not how I did it. It's how much drive I had to go. Get up, drive here, drive there, eat, do my homework. That wasn't the problem. I feared not accomplishing what I wanted. And that's what drove me. So you could tell, it was 9 years of schooling after, you know, coming over here to the U.S. And right now, everything that you study right now, I don't know what your life is going to be, but everything that you have, it will serve the purpose. Because everything, I mean, I wanted to do a video editor for Hollywood, and I realized that wasn't my cup of tea. It was too much work, too graveyard hours, so I changed my pattern, and one thing led to another one, so I started wanting to lose weight, and then I started competing in bodybuilding, and then I went to modeling, and then I'm into acting right now in Hollywood. And you know where all my bachelor's fine arts came into play? The very, very basic core of what they teach you, different from people that have not gone to school, is consistency. That you have to show up every single day. That you know you have to do it no matter how you feel. That's the drive that makes you different from other people. Successful people are losers. They've lost so much. They've lost even more than those people that stay at home watching TV in the sofa. And it's hard to take the losses over and over and over and over. But you know what made the difference? That they never gave up. You know, they gave up because they believe in themselves. So that's why I'm very proud of all of you, that you make it right now, that you're believing in yourself, that you can stay in school. I don't know where your life is going to take you, but I know it's going to be better. Just because you have it in your heart. So let's give a round of applause to all of us, to all of our dreams, and all of our futures. Come on! Come on! Come on! Very proud of all of you. Thank you so much. So will you please fill out the evaluations? Thank you all.